Okay, this video, let's talk about XikeStor SKS3200-8E2X. It is one of their latest switches and is 8 2.5 gig port plus two of the 10 gig SFP plus cages. I personally like their products a lot, and it's very affordable and very stable. And one of the problems with this new switch is it has a very different way to config VLAN. So let's take a look at that. Before that, just gonna show you some pictures of that. It looks nicer than the one I have right now. I have a 4 plus 2 and also a 12 port 10 gig switch. So this is gonna be the interface. It also looks nicer than the one I have right now. But before that, let me show you three scenarios I'm gonna talk about. So the first scenario is VLANs without trunking. So in this case, it will be just port 1 and 2. They are inside of one of the VLANs. And then the port and 6, they are inside of the VLANs. So most likely it's a port segregation and grouping kind of scenario. So there's no trunking. There's no trunking involved. So the second scenario is with trunking. In this case, we have port 1 and 2 on the VLAN 22. Sorry about that. And also on port 9, I think I'm going to actually do port 10, but it's pretty much the same. So port 10 is going to link, is going to be uplink and connect to other switches, and the VLAN 22 will be tagged. Okay, and the third scenario will be a daisy chain. So it's basically we connect something up to a switch and also maybe connect to other switches. So in this case, we want to have the VLAN tags pass through. It's actually by default, it is enabled. It's not like other switches, but I will explain it in a little bit. So let's take a look at the first scenario. How do we config this? Okay, so let's just go ahead and log into the interface. Obviously, it is now on English, but you may also see Chinese here and there. I'm pretty sure they're gonna update that and fix it. But right now, yeah, just ignore if you see anything Chinese. It's been in China anyway, right? So, as we can see, it's quite different. So here we can see port and bridge ID. And also discard untagged tag. That makes sense, right? The most regular, most common way of configuring VLANs is like tag untag, or the Cisco way is the access and trunk, right? So this is quite different. And also they have a tagged VLAN, and basically it has the option of bridge port again and tag type port, bridge ID, external VLAN, internal VLAN. Okay. Confusing? No, not at all. Let me tell you how easy it is. So in the first scenario, we want the port 1 and 2 to group together and to also segregate from other ports. In this case, we can just select them and put them into one of the bridge IDs, the same one. So obviously the bridge IDs is only available from 1 to 63, the default one is 0. So if it's on 0, it's on the default bridge. So in this case, let's do just 10. And we want the ports 4 and 6 on VLAN 20. So we turn on 4 and 6 and we put them on 20. And then apply. And that's it. So technically, the bridge ID is not really the VLAN ID, because VLAN is only, the ID is only transmitted between the trunk ports, right? So these are all access ports. So the bridge ID basically is just telling the ports, okay, you two are together. Only you two can communicate with each other. And the port 4 and 6, same thing. And because they are on the same bridge ID, they talk to each other. They are not going to talk to any other ones because they are on different bridge IDs. So this concept of bridge ID is kind of new, but on many of the network switches internally, they do this. They do the same thing. So yeah, as you can see, it's pretty easy. All right, the next one is actually more common because we need trunking. We want to send the tags over so we can connect some of the ports on this switch to some of the ports on other switches or on routers to do inter-VLAN routing, right? So let's do this scenario. And actually I have devices connected so I can kind of show you the effects. All right, let's disable them, put them all back to the bridge 0. And because we want the port 1 and 2 together, and on the VLAN 22, to make it easy, I'll put it on bridge 22 and apply. Okay, obviously the first step is done, but we also want to make sure our interface 10 is tagged. That's also easy. We go to the tagged VLAN and we enable one of the lines. Just ignore the bridge ports. It's pretty much only valid internally. And we want to do single tag. And in this case, it's going to be port 10 because we want the tag to be on port 10. And then the bridge ID is 22, which matches with those ports, which is here, right? It matches with all of the port 1 and port 2 on bridge 22. Okay, I didn't save that, so it's gone. And 22. And the external VLAN is actually the tags, so we want to tag it 22. Okay, and before I apply, I want to show you the effect. So right now, I have a Synology NAS, and the port 2 is on my local network, which is VLAN 1. So it's on the 88.2.2.1, the address. So after I apply it, and obviously I need to turn off and turn back on the port, it's going to get IP from VLAN 22. Okay, applied. And obviously on port 1, I have the Synology plugged in. So let me, and here's the Chinese. It's just all or check all or uncheck all. It makes sense, right? So port 1, we want to disable it. And you will see this one's gonna, yes, it's disconnected. And we want to enable it. And it should get, it already showed. It's probably because it was on the VLAN 22 IP address, so it just instantly get the IP address already. So 22.100. So that's it. As you can see, it is also fairly easy, but to be honest, there are limits because we have only here the bridge ports 17 to 127. So which means we have only 111 pretty much, right? 11 is like 110 plus one lines of configurations we can put there. So that's a little bit limited if we want to configure a lot of VLANs. But think about it. We only have 8 2.5 gig ports and 2 of the 10 gig ports. Most likely you are not going to configure more than 8 VLANs on this little switch. So for home use, 8 VLANs will be enough. If you really want to configure more, you can, up to about 100 something VLANs, right? But the good news is if you need to daisy chain or pass through any of the VLANs, it's already by default. So we're going to the scenario 3. Well, before that, I just want to emphasize again, let's say if we want to add another port, for example, we want the the port 9 also to tag 22 with the bridge 22, and that's it, right? And this two doesn't need to be matched. So in this case, if we want to tag the VLAN 222, yeah, that's fine. They don't need to be matched. So technically here we have bridge ID 1-63, and yeah, we can configure actually 63 VLANs. Again, that should be way enough for a home or home lab kind of environment. And okay, let me disable this and prepare for the third scenario. So we want a daisy chain on this switch, so it should connect to the port 9 and 10. And we want to pass through, let's say, VLAN 100 to 200. What do we need to configure? Nothing, because by default, it runs a little bit like unmanaged switches. So most of the unmanaged switches, it will just pass through all of the tags, right? Some of the unmanaged switches will actually deny all of the tagged traffic, but most of them, they just let it go and let it run through all of the ports. But there's one difference, because we have bridges, right? So in this case, if you don't want any of the tags to go through any of the ports, we can limit them. So first, if we set any of the ports into a different bridge, if port 9 or 10 received any of the traffic with tags, those traffics is not going to reach the port 1 and 10 because they are segregated by the bridge. On the other hand, if you don't want any of the ports you want them to stay on bridge 0, the default bridge, but you don't want any of the tagged traffic to go to there, then it's okay. You can just say discard tagged, and that'll be it. So I know it's not very flexible, but at the same time, it's easier. I have other switches, no matter like Cisco or other XikeStor switches, or any other managed switches. Usually you need to add a VLAN to allow this VLAN to go through. But again, I think the position of this switch is just home lab, right? Or small offices. Most likely the security is not a excessive need for this scenario. So I totally believe this is not flexible enough. But again, this switch is very cost effective. And if it's your needs, then yeah, you have all of the benefit of this switch. So I hope this video explains how to set up the VLANs in a easy fashion. And if you have any questions, please leave your comment down below, and I'll try my best to answer all of the questions. Thank you.